Hello and welcome to Nikolay's Genetics Lessons, and today's problem is Tay-Sachs disease is inherited as an autosomal recessive in a certain large Eastern European population. The frequency of Tay-Sachs disease is 1%. First of all, this is unrealistic numbers. For example, in United States there are about 20,000 of new cases each year. That means that real numbers would be about 150 times smaller than what we have in our problem. So, question A, the population is assumed to be in Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. What is the frequency of the allele that causes Tay-Sachs disease? So, frequency of the three genotypes that can be made by two alleles would equal to p squared plus 2pq plus q squared, and all this would equal to 1. P squared here stands for the homozygous normal genotype, 2pq stands for the heterozygous genotype, and q squared stands for the homozygous recessive genotype. And homozygous recessive genotype would cause this genetic disorder as a visible phenotypic trait, because people who would belong to homozygous dominant or heterozygous genotype would be phenotypically normal. So we told that people in this population who is going to be affected would make 1%. In other words, if we would do our calculations on the scale between 0 and 1, this is going to be 0.01. And 1 on this scale equals to 100%. So we have to divide 1 by 100, and this is going to be frequency of this phenotype. So how to find a frequency of the allele? Once again, we have here two alleles, allele P and Q, and these two alleles would make 100% or 1, and P stands for the normal dominant allele and Q stands for the recessive allele. So two alleles in diploid organism would make three different genotypes. So we know that frequency of this phenotype, and phenotype here equals to genotype, equals to 0.01. So we can easily find Q. If we know that Q squared equals to 0.01, then Q would equal to square root of this number, so square root of 0.01, and we are going to get 0.1. This is going to be frequency of the allele Q, 0.1, and that means that frequency of the allele P or dominant allele A would equal to 0.9. And now we can find frequency of the heterozygous genotype. According to our formula, frequency of the heterozygous genotype would equal to 2pq, so capital A and small a genotype would equal to 2 multiplied by frequency of the allele P, which is 0.9, and by frequency of the allele Q, which is 0.1. So if we multiply 0.9 by 0.1, we are going to get 0.09, and multiplied by 2, we are going to get 0.18. So now we know the frequency of the heterozygous genotype in this population, and this is going to be 0.18 or 18%. So we also can find the frequency of the people who is going to be homozygous normal. So 0.18 plus 0.01 would give us frequency 0.81. So if we add all these three frequencies, we are going to get 1. So let's check our questions. So question A, if the population is assumed to be in Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, what is the frequency of the allele that causes Tay-Sachs disease? And frequency of this defective recessive allele would equal to 0.1. Question B, what would be the frequency of the heterozygotes? We have found this is 0.18 or 18%. And what is the probability that two heterozygotes would meet each other and marry? And this is easy question. Probability would equal that two people who is going to be heterozygous would meet and mate would equal to frequency of these genotypes, and this is going to be 0.18 multiplied by 0.18, and frequency would equal to 0.0324, or about 3% of all matings would be between two people who is going to be heterozygous. So if we need an answer in percentage form, we just have to multiply this number by 100, because now we are doing all our calculations in this scale. And if we need an answer in percentage form, we have to multiply by 100, and the answer would be 3.24%. So this is going to be an answer for the question C. And question D, in children of such marriages, what would be the frequency of Tay-Sachs disease? And this is also easy question. If two heterozygous people would marry, probability that their progeny would be affected would be as follows. Capital A here, capital A small a here, capital A small a here, and small a here. So as you see, when two heterozygous people would marry, probability that they would have affected child would equal to 1/4. And let's check our last question. What proportion of all Tay-Sachs births are contributed by such marriages? So probability that two people who is going to be heterozygous would marry would equal to 0.324 or 3.24%. So let me write down this number, 0.0324, and probability that this couple would have affected child would be 1/4. So we have to multiply by 0.25. So 0.25 and 1/4 is the same number. And the answer for the last question would be 0.0081. And once again, if we need an answer in percentage form, we need to move this decimal point 2 places to the right. And the answer would be that about 0.81% would account for heterozygous marriages. So two heterozygous people would marry, and this would account for about 4/5 of 1%, and 1/5 would account for something else. For example, this can be explained by new mutations, and this is also unrealistically high number, but basically the purpose of this problem was just to show you the logic how such problems have to be solved if you would have such a problem on your exam. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.